Hi, this is Dr. Raj Singh. I'm a board certified physician in internal medicine and nephrology. I travel nationally to speak at many medical conferences. My practice philosophy is based on healing the body as a whole rather than relying on a symptom and a drug-based approach. Today we'll be discussing the topic of diabetic neuropathy or diabetic nerve disease. As we're seeing more and more cases of diabetes and pre-diabetes, naturally diabetic neuropathy is becoming a big problem. The main issue with this disease or diabetic neuropathy is a loss of sensory function. You know, so the patients have limited ability to perceive certain sensations such as temperature, vibration, pressure, etc. Patients may also notice that they have an unsteady gait, especially when they close their eyes. Now, diabetic neuropathy is a chronic disease. You know, you can have numbness, you can have weakness. This is all from damage to the nerve fibers. Over time, patients may also get like, you know, pain from, you know, damaged nerve fibers. The symptoms tend to start in the toes and feet and often get worse at night. However, symptoms can be present in the hands as well. The big question is, why does this happen? So let's take a look at the underlying pathophysiology. Now, our body is constantly repairing our damaged nerves. Now, in patients with diabetic neuropathy, the damage is happening at a much accelerated rate and our body is not able to keep up with the repair. So if you have diabetic neuropathy, that generally means that you have an imbalance between nerve damage and nerve repair. As you see in this picture, nerve fibers are surrounded by these cells called Schwann cells. These Schwann cells have their own microcirculation and have a very high metabolic requirement. Now, patients with uncontrolled diabetes, the tissues are oversaturated with a lot of glucose. So this extra glucose gets converted into something called as acetyl coenzyme K, coenzyme A, sorry. Now, this molecule gets converted into something called as acyl carnitine. These acyl carnitines are toxic to the Schwann cells and may be responsible for diabetic neuropathy. So in simple terms, these nerve cells are starving, and at the same time, they're also surrounded by these toxic molecules, which leads to significant and often irreversible damage to the nerve fibers. Now, once a diagnosis of diabetes is established, it may take several years for diabetic neuropathy to develop. Now, a certain individual, if they have other risk factors, the symptoms can appear much sooner. So let's take a look at some of the risk factors for, you know, early development of diabetic neuropathy. Of course, uncontrolled diabetes, this is the big one. If your sugar is out of control, you know, the diabetes is going to progress much rapidly. Now, we also know that when blood glucose is brought under control at a rapid rate, the neuropathy initially can get worsened. You know, this is called, you know, this is from inflammation caused by, you know, rapid correction of glucose. So we call this treatment-induced neuropathy or insulin neuritis. Someone who's overweight, so obesity, right? So BMI is directly related to diabetic neuropathy. This is thought secondary to, you know, inflammation caused by insulin resistance. High cholesterol, especially someone has low HDL levels. High blood pressure, someone has uncontrolled hypertension. This will cause further spasm and damage to the microcirculation, may restrict blood flow to the nerve fibers and also the Schwann cells. So now that we understand how we develop diabetic neuropathy, let's see what we can do at some of the treatment options and preventative options. So one first common one is, of course, you know, pain management. So there are certain medications that can be used for treating symptoms of pain. You know, antidepressants such as duloxetine, amitriptyline can reduce pain. Duloxetine, we typically start at about 30 milligrams a day and must be taken on a full stomach because it can cause a significant amount of nausea. Now, gabapentin and pregabalin are very effective. If you're already overweight, I do not recommend pregabalin as it can cause significant amount of weight gain and that can worsen insulin resistance. Of course, you can do capsaicin cream or lidocaine cream for pain. Some studies have mentioned acupuncture as a possible therapy, but the, you know, good data is sort of lacking in that department. What can we do in non-prescription? So of course, control your blood glucose. You know, that's essentially important to prevent and improve diabetic neuropathy. Now, it is possible that, you know, once you start the treatment, the neuropathy may get worse, like we initially discussed, called insulin neuritis. Now, take B12 supplementation. B12 deficiency is so common in patients with diabetic neuropathy. Now, sometimes this is made worse by starting a patient on metformin, which is a commonly prescribed medication. So if you are taking a metformin, it's a good idea to take B12 or B-complex supplementation. Injections, so alpha-lipoic acid. So this is one of my favorite injections to improve nerve pain. It's a very powerful antioxidant that can reduce inflammation in the nerves. Typically, monthly injections are required if the disease is very advanced. Glutathione, another powerful antioxidant, can help reduce inflammation in nerve fibers. NAD. This resets cellular metabolism and provides rapid source of energy at the cell level, which may help facilitate improvement in the cell membrane. So that was a brief overview of diabetic neuropathy, right? So we'll talk about autonomic dysfunction in another video. Now, here is what I recommend to help improve your diabetic neuropathy. You know, control your diabetes, reduce insulin resistance. This can be done by living a healthy lifestyle. You know, lose some weight, take some nutritional supplementation, avoid excessive amounts of insulin, as only this makes only insulin resistance worse. Stop smoking, raise your HDL by taking omega-3, get alpha-lipoic acid injections, glutathione, NAD, B12 or B-complex supplementation. So I hope this was helpful. If you did like the content, please do not forget to like and subscribe. If you didn't agree with something, please do leave a comment as well. I will see you back in a couple of days with another interesting topic. Thank you so much. Take care. Bye-bye.